I started to feel tired of walking around with the part of me that was dead. I felt mummified.
Butterflies winging in.
My name is Diane, and we are butterflies going through life, dodging, empowering, and healing. In November 2017, I went to Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic. There, I got a BBL. Something happened, something led to another, and my blood got infected. I went into a septic shock. People who go into septic shock may develop small blood clots in their blood vessels. My cousin came to visit me, and she looked at my toes. They were blue. They still look normal, they still look good. The only thing was that they were blue. Apart from that blue color, they still look like healthy toes. When blood cannot pass through the blood vessels due to extreme clotting, the body tissues are deprived from the nourishment they need. She took a look. She thought it did not look good. My mother was there as well. She wasn't saying much. I looked at it. She actually took pictures of my toes because I couldn't move much. And she showed it to me, but I just didn't think much about it. I wasn't really actually even able to think much about it. I remember while I was there at that hospital, there was a cream. They were rubbing on it all the time. I never knew what was going on. At that point, I already knew. I went into a septic shock. I knew that my blood got infected, but I didn't know that blood infection could actually cause me to lose my toes. I knew absolutely nothing about it. So after months, I went to a different hospital and we called a doctor, a specialist. I didn't know much about those doctors. I didn't know doctors who took care of feet, or I never had issues of the type, so I didn't know much. I was actually at the hospital and he came and he examined my toes and he said that they were going to be amputated. My family and I, we looked at each other and we were like, oh no, what are you talking about? I am not losing my toes. In my mind, I never thought something like that could happen. I could never, like, I wasn't thinking like that. So this doctor comes and he is so blunt, he is so raw, and he tells me that I'm no longer gonna have toes. And I'm like, I am going to have toes. And this, that was it. He wasn't trying to help me figure out if he could save my toes. He wasn't trying to, you know, he was just like, later on, we're gonna have to get rid of your toes. You're gonna lose those toes. And when he left, I told my mom that I don't wanna have anything else to do with this doctor. He's just too much. I'm hoping that there's something we can do. There's gotta be something we can do. So as time went on, I could see my toes change. Back then, I was thinking that my toes are fine. I could still move my toes. I could wiggle them. So I was thinking, you know, what? It cannot be that bad. I understand it's blue, but the pink, blushy, beautiful color is gonna come back. I'm sure it will come back. I was very positive about it. I didn't care what that doctor said. In fact, I didn't like that doctor because, no, that's not what I needed to hear, you know, after hearing everything else I had already heard. This doctor realized that the tissue was very damaged and that I was going to need amputation. About 1% of sepsis survivors require amputation of a limb or a digits as a result of sepsis. For some patients, it's a limb. For other patients, it might be a toe, a couple of toes, a finger, a couple of fingers, sometimes more. The mortality rate of septic shock is about 40%. As time progressed, the skin became pale and I started to feel some numbness, but I was still okay. I had a lot of other things going on and it was not so worrisome to me. And then it started to be swollen. It was oozing some sort of a fluid. It was also blistering. Didn't like that stage. I did not like that stage. It almost looked as if my skin was burned and then there was liquid. I didn't understand that stage because it really felt as if I was burned. As I would touch it, it was actually oozing fluid. Not a pretty sight. It was not beautiful. I was still hoping that we could save my toes. I was still not in that state of mind. I was still not in the frame of mind where I was going to get them caught up. So I was taking care of my toes, making sure they were clean all the time. I didn't want to talk to a doctor. I didn't want to hear about the doctor. I didn't want to talk about amputation. Whatever activity I loved doing, I thought back then, I felt I needed to have toes to do them. Okay. Swimming, as I mentioned in previous videos, I love swimming. I love biking. I love taking long walks. I was gonna need my toes. I was gonna need my feet. I was not having it. My toes started to turn dark red. It started to turn purple. It was just taking different forms. It was going through phases and stages. It was changing quickly too. I mean, I thought it was quickly, but actually it was taking months and months. But I was still going through my activities, whatever I needed to do, because I still had to learn how to walk. There was a lot of stuff that was going on. I still had to go to dialysis. I was still just like hoping that my toes were gonna get better. I was still wearing normal shoes. I was wearing whatever shoes I wanted to wear because I was not in pain. My toes were becoming numb, and as time progressed, it was becoming even more numb. It was feeling like I didn't even have toes like that. It was different. The feeling was different. There was definitely more numbness as time progressed.
On the right foot, he got rid of the little toe, the foretoe, some of the middle toe, and some of the index toe, and also the tip of the big toe. My toes can still feel numb, and they are a little bit sensitive still, and the nails are extremely hard, so I don't like to play too much with it or let anyone do things to it. The left foot was not as affected as the right one. On the left foot, we only got rid of some of the little toe, and the foretoe was kind of affected, but he did not really do much to it. And also, the middle toe was a little bit affected too, but not as much. It's mostly inside. It's an inner feeling that I have with that toe.
I had to go to about 5 visits after the procedure. The pain was managed really well. It was kind of hard in the beginning. It was painful. I didn't feel like I was ready to see my toes. So the first time after the procedure, the first time we went, I was just filming it, but I was not looking at it, and I didn't watch that video until later. I didn't know how my life was gonna change after having this procedure. I was worried that it was never going to be the same again, but then I was going through a lot more. I was more understanding of experiences in life and things that we go through, and I was just like, really in that state where I am not those toes, really. Those toes are part of me, but those toes are not determining who I choose to show up as or the person that I truly am. I was still very positive. Of course, I was still actually dancing a lot because I was all about happy vibe. I was all about elevating myself, you know, thinking forward, and I was always imagining an extremely beautiful life. I just kept talking about beauty and all that. So it was really helpful in my healing process. And the beginning, of course, was not hard because it took a while for my toes to fully heal, or whatever fully heal means, really. In the beginning of the healing process, after the amputation, I was getting hurt a lot. Like my younger boy was always stepping on my foot. So all the time I was bleeding all the time. And because of the numbness, I wasn't always used to, you know, not feeling that part of my body. So I was always hitting my toes and things were happening all the time. There was blood for a long time. In fact, I was bleeding for months after the procedure, because I had to get used to the fact that I didn't have toes and the numbness.
This is really paining me. I hurt it all the time, and it's just a mess.
So So I was bleeding a lot. And then in the very beginning, I also had to go through phantom sensations where I thought I had those and I would look at my feet and I didn't have those. This was not easy too. If you could think of something, I probably went through it with these toes. But I was determined to get back to whatever a normal life meant for me. I love wearing high heels. So after like 3 months, 4 months, I started wearing high heels again. It wasn't easy. And I got back into my swimming. It wasn't easy. I got back into my biking. It was actually easier than I thought, but I needed a lot of time to heal, basically, for me. It took a long time because I kept getting into accidents with my toes. There is really no stopping me. And there is that feeling that always comes to me where it's like, I've gone through a lot. So there is, what can I go through that could just break me? You know, I have gone through this, I've gone through that. And I'm telling you, butterflies, dancing can be quiet healing, okay? Dancing can be quiet healing when you're going through pain, when you're going through traumatic events. And of course, there is meditation. There's a lot of stuff you can do to feel better when you're going through something major in your life. And of course, being flexible, doing some yoga is not gonna hurt you if you can actually handle it. If you're experiencing similar situation or even worse, don't waste your time on losing hope. Trust me, there is always light at the end of the tunnel. Understand that everything will eventually come together, and with a positive mindset, you will heal faster. It doesn't matter what you are experiencing. It is never the end. You know, it's like, I have this terrible depression. Just give it time and have a positive mindset. You will eventually get out of it. Trust my words, you will eventually get out of it. If you like this video, please give me a thumb up and do not forget to subscribe and comment. Let me know if you've gone through similar situations. Let me know if you have been amputated and how it went, or if you're about to get amputated. Let me know, butterflies. Let me know what you are going through. We are a family. We are one family. Do never underestimate the power of the light within you. Feel better, heal yourself. Goodbye.